So I think one of the really interesting things around AI is there's definitely this moment of hype, but actually when you talk to members of the public, what they're unaware of is they've been using artificial intelligence technologies in their everyday life for a long time now. So I think artificial intelligence, there is no one single definition. A lot of the time when we talk about artificial intelligence, we're actually talking about big data or data processing modeling. If we think back to the early concept of what a computer was a human who entered data and processed data, and humans are still very much linked to artificial intelligence. A good example one of our partners gave was the machine tagged a painting as having an old lady. The person in the painting was actually 39. The person who presented this case study was the same age and said, well, actually, I wouldn't consider that to be old. Introducing a critical language around AI is making members of the public start to consider what data they give to some of these big tech companies. So actually, we're starting to question, well, who's programming the machines and who's authenticating what the machines are creating. So the network came together to develop a series of small working groups that provide the platform for museum professionals to get together and talk about the challenges they're facing when it comes to using AI, but also to share some examples of good practice. Museums are really interested in AI for two main reasons. AI allows them to better understand their visitors and creates new opportunities to develop programs that are more attuned to what their visitors want and what might attract potential new visitors. One of the main outcomes of the network is going to be a toolkit for museum practitioners. Our case studies are going to really kind of peel back the layers to how much did it cost, how long did it take to implement, what skills are needed to make this work. But we're also interested in AI from a collections focus. If you think a lot of museum collections is somebody travelled the world 100 years ago and emptied their suitcase, that probably wasn't documented that well, so we don't know where it came from, we don't know what it is, we don't know how old it is. AI allows us to start to unpack some of those undocumented objects. It's never going to be as good as a curator, but it's faster, it's quicker, and it's cheaper. So one of the conversations we've been looking at is this idea of, is it better to have content that's not quite perfect, but adds to the conversation, than have no content at all? Museums provide a really good platform for debate. For our public events at the Barbican Centre, we had a series of experts sitting around the table, and what we found was members of the public quite enjoyed being able to ask questions, to unpick some of the headlines that they've seen about these technologies and ask, well, what does this mean for me?